Hi, today I'm going to talk about how to add, modify, edit the DNS records in the DNS zone of a domain name. Domain name systems translates internet domain names and host names to its respective IP address and vice versa. The DNS automatically translates the domain name that is entered on the web browser to its respective IP address of your web hosting package. However, the DNS zone of a domain name will only be active if you are using your partially branded or fully branded Orderbox name service. So let's go ahead and see how to add, modify, and edit the DNS records for a domain name in the DNS zone. In order to set the DNS records for a domain name, you need to first log into the domain control panel. So let's click on products, list all orders, and select the domain name for which you want to modify or add the DNS records. The most important thing that you need to look out before you add a record is what are the name servers for a domain name. If the domain name is using our partially branded name servers, that means you can add the records for the domain name in our DNS zone. At any point of time, if you're using a third-party name servers, the records for the domain name needs to be added at the third party's DNS zone. In this case, the domain name domainsfordemo.com is using our name servers, and hence we'll be adding the records in our DNS zone. So in order to go to the DNS zone, we just scroll down to the last option, and that is DNS management panel, where we can add the required records for the domain name. Here we click on the option Manage DNS, where it takes you to the DNS zone where all the records for the domain name can be added. Here we see multiple records like A records, 4A records, MX, CNAME, NS, TXT, SRV, and SOA records. Depending upon what record needs to be added inside the DNS zone, you can click on the respective record and add the entries. Right now we're just going to check how to add an A record. When I click on the A record option, it gives me an option of entering the host name, the destination IP address, as well as the time to live, that is the TTL. The host name, if I want to add the records for the domain name, that is domainsfordemo.com, I leave the host name as blank and I enter the IP address that is required. For example, I can add an IP address like 204.168.186.24. So if this is the IP address of the hosting package, I can add the IP address over here, modify the TTL depending upon the TTL provided by the hosting provider, and click on Add Record. This adds the record for the domain name. Once you click on Add Record, you will see that the record for the domain name domainsfordemo.com has been added over here. At any point of time, if you want to modify a record or delete the record, you can just click on the option that is the domain name. And you'll see two options on the top. One says modify record and delete record. At any point of time, if you think that you need to change the IP address of a domain name, you can click on modify record, come over here and modify the IP address of the domain name and click on modify record. This makes the changes to the IP address that was added and saves it to the DNS zone. If you want to delete the record, you can just click on the option and delete the record from the DNS zone, and this will be permanently deleted from the DNS zone of the domain name. If you want to add a multiple record or a subdomain for a domain name, you can just click on Add a record once again, and here you can mention in the host name the subdomain that you want to create. For example, if I want to add a record for www, I can mention www in the host name, add an IP address for which I want the domain name to point to, the TTL time, that's the time to live, that is 14400, and then click on Add records. The subdomain record is also added. Now, once the records are added in the DNS zone of a domain name, you need to wait for minimum 4 to 6 hours for the propagation to complete, after which your domains will resolve to the IP address that you have mentioned inside your DNS zone. Similar activity needs to be done if your domain is pointing to a third-party name service. The third-party DNS zone will also provide you with these records that can be added in their DNS zone. Kindly add those records and wait for 4 to 6 hours for the propagation to complete, after which the domain will start resolving to the IP address mentioned in the panel.
Hope this was helpful. In case you have any queries, reach out to us using the details given in the description box below. For more such videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel.